About the term logic, assume that you have a store that and you sell the 15 products or more than 15 products, and there is a problem with managing the inventory. The inventory is the important for the stock, stock the product. If you have a store, you must to manage inventory to about quantity of the product, how to hold is holding cost or something that in you can learn in the supply chain management. So this is important thing for manage the store in the back end. Then when you have the store and maybe you are the manager, so you need to a program that you can monitor all the details of the inventory. The program that must collect and manage all products in the inventory. And moreover, when you have the data of the product in the inventory, you need a summary report to tell you about the cost and the profit, or about some some cost that is occur when you hold the products in the inventory. Then so in the details number one and number two, you have to create the table for the product detail. The product detail is maybe contain the product name, ID, price of the product, expiry date, or the defected, or something about involved with the product. And then when you manage the inventory, you need to create a history log for to receive the product. When you receive the product, when you sell the product, and ending inventory. So these are the details that you have to contain it in the table. You must contain the date to tell the user which date, what is the update in the inventory, product name, because you have many products in the inventory. Beginning inventory, demand is the sale quantity or the customer need to or the power of you can buy the product in the inventory or in the shop. And expiry, you can change the expiry date or expiry product with the defect product, infected product, or something that you cannot buy this product in to the customer. You can categorize the expiry for the unsale product. And ending inventory, the summary of the quantity of the product in the inventory after in the date that you specify. And order, this order is only yes or no, because if the product is low, quantity is the quantity of product is low, you must to be order. The product is must be ordered. So if you need to order the product, so you can check it that it must to be ordered. And you must have the order quantity. If order is yes, the order quantity is must be filled. And you need receive. If product is arrived, you need to enter the unit receive. And it will share in the product inventory. In the history log, user can enter the demand, the sale quantity in each day. Then the program will calculate the ending inventory. Furthermore, the program must notify the user when the product quantity in the stock is low for the user can order the can decide to order the product or not. If the user order the product, the user must enter the order quantity. And then you can specify the number of days for transporting the product, because when you order the product, you need to wait for the transporting product or the product received. If the product arrives, the history log must be updated on the unit received, or you can enter it when the product is received. Then history log must be stored in an Excel file, and the program will read the history log in the Excel file and show it in the program. So you need to store the all data in the Excel file, ALSF. And then the program will read it from the Excel file and show on in the program. If the product are expired, or you can indicate that it is defect or it's depend on your design. Well, because some product can be expired or some product is defect or infect, or more function with the product, some product. The program will automatically update the expired quantity in the history log. And another option, another function of the program is to create the summary report from the history log. For present the following, in history log, you can summarize the data or summarize about. You must summarize history log for present the detail in the report. By a report interval, any either from day one, or you can from the interval from 15 days ago or something that you can change to present, and show the product name, cost, revenue, and profit. In the summary report, user can sort all the data that you can use sorting algorithm for sort the data. You can sort product name, cost, revenue, or profit, and you can sort in the ascending and descending. Moreover, you can the program must be generate chart for all data. If I need to see the chart of cost, I can see it by push the button and generate the chart to show. Then the summary report can be exported to an Excel file to be analyzed in the Excel file, or you can insert the chart or anything in the Excel file. But in the program must be generated chart too. For the history log, you can add some feature about filter by date or filter by product name, as depends on your design. You can decide about the filter. The filtering you maybe you can use to you can use the search algorithm for search about the product name or date. To filter the data and show it. These are the term projects. So you need to decide the table about the product detail table, history log table, and small table that you need you think that is necessary to is necessarily useful for your project. for your data that you can use in the program. But I think if there are two necessary tables, these are the product details and the history log table. And then I show you the useful function to apply in the project. So in this project, it involves the list. The list is is mainly used in the project and how to create the data. This can be created to the table. The table is the n dimensional of array. Which programming language do we need to use? You need to use the Mathematica programming. Okay. The table like in the mathematics, you can think about the matrix. The matrix is like a table, but the matrix is contained only the number as elements. But table you can store any type of data. Or you can learn in the discriminant, it's called tuple. Or the n dimensional array. In the previous, you learn about to create the list by table, or you can assign it directly by use the blanket. Like an array in the C programming. Now, you can create the list or table by by read file, list the data in the file and import it to store in the variables. The first function that you can use is the notebook directory. Notebook directory will return the path or directory of the notebook. Notebook is the Mathematica file that you coding. For example, I save this file in the desktop, so it will return the path of the of my desktop. You can see this part. You can notice that if the part is exists, you can see that it can be opened. This bar will be shown. If the part is incorrect, this bar cannot be shown because it cannot find the directory, so it cannot do further operate. And another useful function to something about to import the read file or read Excel file. That is the import function. You can use the import function as in C programming, you use read file, write file function to read the text file. But in the Mathematica, you can use any file. You can read any file by using the import function. You can read the text file. You can read the Excel file, Word file, by using the import. Before. You can see my Excel file. There are some data that is not involved in your project. It's this data for solving in the shortest path. Solving Selman problem. And I will import this data into the list variable in the Mathematica. My Excel file is customer.dist.xlsx. And I use this part to this part from the for my call the notebook directory function. Then I run this program. I run this function. It will return the data that stored in the customer distance. You can see the blanket. There are three blankets. It means that the data variable will be three-dimensional array. It's a three-dimensional array. The first blanket is mean that the sheet of the Excel. If you have many sheets, it will store in the first dimension or the first level of the three-dimensional array. The second is the row and then is the column of the table. If you want only table in the Excel, you can indicate the element one of the three-dimensional array. It will reduce the dimensional to from three-dimensional to the two-dimensional array. Then I will show you. I use the table form to represent the data in the table form. In the previous, I declare the part or it means I assign the part by the notebook directory function. So then I use the variable part that is for the notebook repository, and then I use the concatenate string symbol. This is a string join. And then run this function. The path will be the path of this notebook, and I concat the string by the customer.dist.excel. And the result will be the same as the data that I use the string as the path. These are the way the way to import or read file in the MathAmerica. Then you need to write file in your project. You need to write the summary report to the Excel file. So you need to learn how to write file or export the data into the file format. The first function that I need to teach you is the file name join. File name join is equal to join the string in the to join the string of the path of the file path. In the previous slide, we have path variable that indicate the path of my desktop. And then I need to create the part of customer distance Excel. So you can see that this part is correct because this bar is appear, and you can open it by click the open, or you can import by click the import. This bar is a utility bar that can help you to do something further. I will show you if I create the long the part that is not exist in my desktop. The example.pdf is not exist in my desktop. you can see that the utility bar will not show the open function to open your example.pdf, but it can see as the only the string, the parse string. You can split as substring or convert to uppercase because it detect only the the output is the string only. But in this output, it can detect that it is the part that exists in your computer. So it can use the system open to open your file or import the data in your file or open file directory. Open file directory will open the desktop directory. Or you can press more to see the more to see the further function that can handle the output 12. Now we need to export some data. We can use the export function to export the data into the file format. For example, I need to export the data tree. The data tree is data one, the data in the first row. In the first row of the data variable is the header of the table. To export, I need to use the file name joy function. And I create the header.xlsx. This file will not exist in your computer, but when you use export, it will create the file, the header xlsx in the specified part. And I use the table form to store the data tree as the table form. If this function is successfully export the file, it will be shown like this. It will show on the output 6 as output 16. You can see the header.xlsx and the data will be like in the Excel file like this from the table form. And back to to export the table to the data tree. Your friend asked me, is table form necessary here? So we will remove the table form. the results are the results are the same. Then if I use tomorrow's, it will be the data set will be the table. And then I export without the table form. The result will be collect without the table form function to generate the data tree as a table before export in the Excel file. Why I use the table form before export? Because in the previous version of Mathematica, need the table form to store the table data into the Excel file appropriately. But in this version, I think it can fill the data into the Excel appropriately without the table form function. If I change the header .lsx to be the text. You can see the header.txt and the data will store like this. It will show as the output 20. When you store the data or the value in the variable to the text file, it means that you store its value as a text, as a string. Okay, I will show you to report the text file. You can see the utility bar. The output 25. The program, the Mathematica program will detect this output as a string. You can see that is importing send to stream or switch string, and you can compare with the output 20. You can see that it can use the transpose like the matrix, transpose matrix that swap about row and column. And you can use the display as a table or matrix. Flatten I will talk about later. You can see that it cannot use output 25 as the data as an array or list. So if I assign output 26 to the value in the data for variables, data for variable is the string type. If you need to change this string to be the list, you can need more function. That is the two expression. You can use two expression. Two expression function will convert the string the convert the string into the list that the that the string is format. You can see only one row that the second row of the data C can be converted to the string convert to the array or list. Okay. This is the how to write five in the Math America. And then we will talk about the rearrange and restructuring list. In the C programming, you use array. Use array that when you want to declare the array, you must declare the number of elements in the array, or you can declare the number of elements in the array later by using the dynamic array. Then you need to use linked list for the data that you can specify the number of the element in the array. Then you can use in the Mathematica you can generate the list like a linked list, and you can add more elements by use join function. Not only join function can be used to add element in the array or list. You can use append. You can use append function to add more elements in the array, but in the join function, it will concatenate the two lists or more than two lists to be the one to be a single list. For example, I have a list A and list B, and list A has A, B, C as elements, and list B has DEF as element, and I generate list C by join list A and list B by using join function. And this is the output of join list A and list B. You can use join to make list as a linked list. First, you can declare the list D as an empty list, and then you can use list D equal join list D join itself and add some elements. So I add element one. So you can see that one element will be added in the list D. If you need add the element again, you can use join. And you can see that number two will be added in the list D. You can use join to make the list into linked list like C programming in the Mathematica. And another function that useful for your project is take function. The take function will give you the first n element of list. For example, you can see the list C has 6 elements A, B, C, D, F, and I need first four elements. So I use the take function and the output will be like this, A, B, C, D. However, you can use another format for take some element in the list. I think you remember that when you need the first element in the list, you use the symbol like this. The one will be indicate the first element of the list C, or if you change to 2, it means that the second element in the list C. And when you run, you can get the second element in the list. So if you need more than one element, you can use list to tell the program that I need the first element, third element, and the fifth element of the list C, and it will return you the three elements at a time. Another function is replace part. Replace part will replace some element that you want to change in the list. For the example, list C, I need to change the second element from the list C. It will be it is B, and convert B to BG. I use the replace part. When I run the list C will be returned, and the second element that is B in the previous will be G at the list end. And then I need to tell you about the delete function. Delete function will remove the some element in the list. In the example, you can see that I need delete the element at the second and the fourth position in the list C. Okay, first I need to delete the second element in the list C, and then if I need to remove element at the position 4, you can see that element D will be removed. If you need remove more than one element, you need the pattern like this. You can see that B and D is removed from the list C. B and D are removed from the list C. sometimes you can use keyword or to select or element in the list. You can see when I put all in the in as the index of the data, it will return all the data in the output 54. These are the necessary functions that you can use in the project. There are more useful functions that you can learn in the Mathematica, or you can go to the help. You type list and press F1. You can see the manual of the Mathematica and you go to the related guide and select the list manipulation. The list manipulation it tells you about something in some function that involve with the list. For example, the first is to return the first element in the list. Last is it is a function that return the last element in the list. Append like a join function. Because part I tell you later, I tell you before. Select, you can use select to select some element in the list. And you can see this topic rearrange and instruction list. You can use Fat 10 to convert the two-dimensional or n-dimensional array to be one-dimensional array. For the example, this Fat 10 this list is more than one-dimensional. It's more than one dimension, and when you use pattern, it will convert this list into the one dimension. And you can study about this function to help you create the project. Next will be the function to present your data or to rearrange the data into the table form. The first one is grid. The grid function will format your list into the table. In this bar, you can select the style that you need to change. Or you can use frame. you can use frame frame or to insert the insert or border in the grid. When you use Git, you can change many style. You can change many style of the grid. You can press F1 to see the option of grid that you can show the data. And table form will generate the list as the table data, but there are only one style like this. You can use grid with the data. This advantage of using grid. If you use grid, the text will be distorted by because the width of the column is not enough to display some text, but you can change it. You can use the manual of grid, and you can see the option for the frame. You can see that the frame is two or frame is all. It will be different from use true or two and true. Or you can add border in a specific position of the table. You can use spacing to extend the space. For each data in the table, or you can use item style to change the size of the data. You can see the application to the application in the manual will show you about the useful example for using grid function. And possible issue is interesting for the example to use in your code. When to show the data in the program, you can use you should use grid function. It will be more style to show the data, and you can add some border in the data. But when you need to show simple style of the table data, you can use table form. The last one is the association. Association will generate the structure that's binding the value with the key. For example, I generate the product or product variable. The product variable has some details. For the first one is ID. ID is one product. This is a product name, or I use a product. It's a product is pencil and price is 15. 15 can be the number. When I evaluate the input 62, the output will be the associate that has three keys and three values. The first key is ID, and the second key is product, and the third key is price. When you want to use the value in the association, you can type the variable as the function and type the key that you need to acquire. When you use product ID, it will return one. Or you change product, you change the ID to product. It will return the pencil that you buy the value to the product key. Or you change price. Association can inherit the property of the list. The property of the list or the array that you use in the C programming. When you want to use association as a list, you can select the first element by using the array style like this. This will return the first element of the association. The first element of the association is one. The first, the element in the association are the values in the association. When you want to select the second element in the product list, it returns the pencil. Okay, your friends asked me if we want to make a list of association. So you can see this slide. I create the table of the association. The table of association will be the list of association. A random word that it will generate some words in the dictionary to assign in the keyword. So you can see that I have 10 associations. I have 10 structure of the data that has two keys. That these are number and word. Number one will have the word horticulture. And number two have word surveillance. Then you can use the list of association the same as you use list. For example, I select the first list of the list. It will return this structure of the element. The second dimension, I select number, it will return one. if I change from 1 to 8, if you return 8, that is the number, the value of number keyword. So I change it to word. Transversely is the word of this key. Or you can use to represent the word key. Or you can use like this. As association it will be the this element. Is as the association, and when you use association as a function, and put the key which is no, which is number, and if you return it or word, you if you change the key to word, it will be returned transversely word. This useful for you you apply in the project, because if you want if you use the to put the number of dimensional array or number of element in the array, it can be confused when you have many records of the data. But when you use association, the key will be treated as the header of the data, or the or the column of the data. So it is useful to use association as the table structure of the data. These are the useful functions that you can apply in the project. And if you what do you think if you need more function that to help you to do the project, please tell me. In the project, you need to design the UI. You can use the manipulate function to design the UI. You can know that manipulation function have to pass that when you present the program. The first one is the display data, and the second part is the control. You need to decide the control button or control type to control the display data in the first part. When I talk about the project, I forgot to show you the some example of the management of inventory. This is the data for manage inventory to to order the to order the products and see and review the ending inventory. For this data, you can see that they want to you can see it's stored in the day 1 to 1,000. And the product has the beginning inventory is 1,500. So in this problem, the products will be ordered every 6 days. So you can see the demand column, that tell you how many products that you can sell. So in your project, you can use a day column, beginning inventory, units received, demand, ending inventory. Ending inventory will be the summary of the beginning inventory and units and minus the demand satisfied. In your project, you must to minus with only demand. You don't need to create the demand satisfied because demand satisfied. In this data, it will be the statistical data from the management system. Order you can use yes or no or 0 or 1 to tell the program that you need to order. Need to order more quantity of product. When you need to order, you can enter the number of quantity. So in the history log, you need to decide. You must contain the beginning inventory, unit received, demand, ending inventory, order quantity, these are the examples that you can design the table to store the data in the history log. And you don't need to add more this column because it is deep for the inventory management. I think you don't know holding cost or shifted cost or about this variable. That's all. Do you have any question? Can we export the file if we use car version? I'm not sure how it can work with the car version. I never tried it again. I never tried it. For cutting the day to the product alive, maybe you need to decide another table to order the order the product, and in the table will contain the arrival time or the transporting day. You can for some for some problem about the product arrive, you can add more table to solve your problem. For the question that you asked me, can we export the file if we use car version? So I show you that it can work when you use the car version. But in the car version, I think the notebook directory function cannot work. If you store the Excel file in your computer, so the notebook directory cannot work when you use the car version. It will return the path of the part of the directory in the cloud. Okay, it doesn't work. It cannot light the file. It cannot light the file test.txt in my desktop when I use the export function. But it can detect that this directory exists for export. But it cannot write the file into my PC. Maybe it cannot connect to my PC directly, or maybe I use the tile plan. It cannot use the export. It cannot use the external resource or connect to the external resource as my PC. Because I cannot to access to my PC. If you don't need to pay, I think you can use the standalone version. Maybe I'm not sure that if the basic plan, if you it can write your file into your PC. Yes, 15 day prior legally. If you have two emails, you can get two license for 15 days. I have license for 15 days.
Do you want to talk in group after this, or you will manage by yourself? Do you want me to separate the Zoom breakout room for you or not?